We are very, very excited. It's an interesting program, and more importantly, we look forward to moving our beneficiaries from being climate victims to climate heroes.
Uganda is one of Africa's biggest exporters of quality Arabica and Robusta coffee. However, the crop production is largely affected by the climate change. For this reason, coffee farmers have been urged to adopt better farming methods. Among these methods is growing indigenous shade trees that can absorb toxic gases, retain soil fertility and nutrients, among other benefits.
The idea is to see that farmers are decarbonizing their value chains. And in this one specifically is the coffee value chain. We are a solidarity that we want to look at this in different aspects. We want to look at the tea value chain, we want to look at coffee already right now, cocoa and cereals and many others. We have already started working at the business cases for these products for gene, and we want to see how to walk the talk.
Kimenya further reveals that farmers will also be given financial assistance to help them improve their coffee production. This is in addition to giving them free coffee seedlings, seedlings of indigenous shade trees, and helping them find market for their coffee.
Participatory, we work with farmers to access tree seedling germplasm, work with institutions like the National Coffee Research Institution and the National Forest Research Institution to provide site-specific matching, whereby trees, we know the specific trees that can be planted in which cropping systems and what management aspects can be employed, so that the coffee productivity is not reduced and this should be sustainable. And if you do that, we incentivize the farmers to change their behavior to retain trees in coffee farming systems for a longer period of time. And we work with our international partners, the Rabobank, to connect them to the Econ carbon market.
We store carbon in the trees, then we are ensuring that we are reducing on the impacts that would have otherwise affected agricultural productivity. The other hand is also helping to contribute to income enhancement for the farmers, because now the carbon is being sold in the international markets under the voluntary carbon scheme.
Felicity Pamira Achan, the executive director of Solidaridad Network, revealed that their main objective is to ensure that farmers can remain productive even amidst the harsh climatic changes. The five-year project will benefit over 50,000 farmers in Uganda and Kenya.
Help the farmers to do climate agricultural practices that will help boost their productivity and in a way will increase their income. Meanwhile, this carbon farming that we are looking at today will have an additional income stream for the farmer, because the farmer is going to be compensated for the emission that is going to reduce through planting trees in the coffee gardens. But not only that, we are so happy that we shall directly contribute to our Uganda National Contribution commitment that we made through reduction of emissions that we are targeting by 2030.
Story by Peace Navuga for the news.
3, 2, 1.